I'm Tom Stoltman. I'm a professional strongman. I'm 25 years old from Scotland.
I'm Tom Stoltman's older brother, Luke Stoltman. I'm 34 still. We're the Stoltman brothers and we're going to take over the world of strongman.
Stoltmans. I've got Scotland's strongest man for the last 2 years. Came third in Britain's finalist in World's Strongest Man. And then recently just third at Loos, World Ultimate Strongman. That's probably my biggest ones to date right now.
Yeah, so for my titles, I'm five times Scotland's Strongest Man. I've won Scotland five times. We were the first Scotsman in, I believe, since 2002, 2003 to make it to the final. The top 10 of World's Strongest Man. First brothers in the history of World's Strongest Man to make the final, which is pretty awesome. And like Tom says, I was also competing in Dubai in World's Ultimate Strongman, where I placed second, which was pretty exciting.
I think we're the first brothers as well to place podium on an international competition.
Yeah. I mean, the brother thing, obviously, that's a big thing for us. That's the World's Strongest Brother title. I'd say officially now.
Yep.
For me, I think my favourite title was probably my first one was the Scotland's Strongest Man title. I mean, when I got suggested to compete in Scotland's Strongest Man, I never thought I would ever do well, let alone win it. And that first title was pretty special to me. Obviously, when we win the World's Strongest Man, that might surpass that. But yeah, at the moment, Scotland's Strongest Man first title for me.
Yeah, taking Luke's Scotland's Strongest Man title finally. After because I think I was competing 3 years, but I didn't think I was ever going to get it. So I think my first Scotland's, and also just Worcester Chanel, because just to get myself on the international podium, both of us, it's good. But yeah, World's Strongest Man is going to be the next one. Mm. My best thing is still, I think, is Europe's Strongest Man, Stone Run. When I finished it, they went round and helped Luke. Mm-hmm. I just didn't really feel it when I was there, but see, watching it back and getting the crowd and stuff, that was mad.
I think that was a special moment. I think in strongman history, I think that was a pretty epic moment. I mean, in front of 10,000 plus people in Leeds Stadium, Tom just smashed the strongman. It was up to 200. He just popped it up, no problem. Then a wee celebration, and then he came round. And like my sleeves had sleeves on, they were slipping. I was just going to walk off, and Tom said, "Oh, come on, get it." And then I managed to get it up, and then it was like a chest bump. Yeah. That we did, and then kind of celebrated to the crowd with arms up.
I mean, it's still, a lot of people talk about it still today. Yeah. I'd say it's one of their best moments. The crowd was, I was like petrified. I was like, Jesus.
It's a standing ovation, so.
That's louder than, I go football matches, it's louder than football games, and I'm just like, this is special, this is cool, So, yeah, it's cool to be part of massive, big crowds, and they obviously do help. Like in training, it's so. You're not motivated. You have maybe one or two people shouting, but see when you have about 10,000 people shouting, you get 10% stronger no matter what.
For sure. I think this year, out of all the British athletes, I think Tom and I have been the highest place in the majority of the shows. So going into Britain's, I would say that we're probably, along with Bishop, Abbott Bishop.
That's three of the favourites.
We're probably.
No disrespect to you, but I think that's a podium. That's two and then Bishop.
But yeah, we're going into, we're wanting to win.
Yeah.
I've never said that. I've been going into Britain's Strongest Man before, but yeah, that's our, I think we're both
only one of us can win four, but I hopefully we're joint in points and joint in combat, so we...
I want to win.
I'll take half the title and you can take half of it.
Yeah, so definitely, going into Britain's Strongest Man 2020, looking for that title. Taking it back to Scotland, not been the first time, I think, since the 90s, I think, and Forbes Cowan won it last. Who's the last Scotsman to win it, so it'd be awesome if one of us could take the title home back up to the Bonnie Highlands.
Yeah, as I said, I don't mind, the aims are obviously to win it, but only one of us can win it, so podium for both of us would be, the two highest places on the podium would be the best outcome, whatever way.
I get quite emotional competing with Tom, because he's my baby brother, he's 10 years younger than me. People ask if there's a rivalry as such, and there is to a certain point. I mean, we want to beat each other, but what people don't realise is that it's an individual sport. I want to beat everyone. So it's not just the fact that it's Tom. Tom's where we compete when we're in that competitive zone, he's another athlete, but at the same time, he's still my brother. So it's great because I want to see Tom do as well as he can. Tom's got, I would say, probably the most potential out of all strong men in the world at the moment. But I just want to see Tom live up to that potential. So, I mean, it's for me, it's pride. I just have a great deal of pride for watching Tom compete. But yeah, no, it's nice to be the older brother, you know, because I think I've kind of paved the way for Tom. Once I started, there wasn't anyone in our family doing strongman, so I kind of got into the gym through nothing more than my own kind of want, and then kind of started competing, and then everything just really snowballed from there. We saw the potential in Tom. Tom came into the gym, and yeah, just kind of nice to just, I wouldn't say pay, but just open that door for Tom, and he just walked through and kind of, you know, did it his way, and that's what he's certainly doing. So it's pretty awesome. Yeah, it's cool.
We've got rivalry, but I think we spur each other on. I mean, like, as you see with the stones and stuff, like at Woos and Europe's, I don't think Luke would have got the one at Woos, you know, after doing the 190. You know, he came back and I just ran on the stage and, you know, just shouting from this, you know, our sides. And even Luke, when he shouts me on the deadlift and stuff, you know, we're competing against each other, but we still want each other to like break records and make history. And, you know, I love doing it with him. And I think if Luke didn't have me and I didn't have him, I don't think we'd be as good as we were right now, you know, because like we push each other in training. We know like our weaknesses, we know our strength, we know. I think, yeah, we've just got that advantage over a few people that we can work together. Plus, it's an individual sport, but we help as much as we can during it. So.
Like Batman and Robin, aren't we? The dynamic duo.
Wallace and Gromit. I think if Luke didn't do strongman, I would be playing football or doing some sort of ball sport, because before
the balls.
Yeah, that's why I'm good at stones. But before the gym, all I played was football, or, you know, I just like playing anything to do with a ball. So I don't think I would have got into the gym, but not seriously. I doubt I would have been anywhere near a strongman level, you know. The only reason I got into it is because I went to watch Luke do his first Scotland Strongman, and I got the buzz then, and that's when I was like, yeah, this is for me. But if Luke didn't compete, I would never, ever have thought to do strongman. It would have been a lot on the mind. Ballet dancing or something with me, like gymnastics. I was a good gymnast.
He
wasn't a good gymnast.
So that's a different story. I'll show you, like, that's a different story.
Yeah, strongman is an individual sport, but, you know, we do show massive encouragement to everyone, and I think it's just the respect we have for.
Just because we're so close to everyone, I think we're just like one big family. I mean,
it's a family, but also we all know how hard you have to work to get. So when Eddie Hall went for that 500 kilo deadlift,
yeah, everybody wanted to see it.
You know how hard he's worked for that deadlift, and it's like when Tom goes out and does the Mark Stone, everyone knows how hard he's worked for that. And so it's because we go through it every day, so we kind of feel that kind of in the guys that are going out to lift. Yeah, we want to be.
Everybody wants records. I mean, it's, again, it pushes the sport, doesn't it? You know, everybody wants to see Eddie Dalton 500K and showed him so much support. And I think everyone backed, all the strongmen were backing him. And look at what strongmen he had around him, didn't he? You know, it's cool to see. But, yeah.
I don't think we have, like, in comparison to other sports, there's not that many big egos as such. As Tom says, it's our family, kind of our friends. It's nice to see our friends kind of, you know, achieve what they can achieve. And we wouldn't want to go out and beat anyone on a subpar performance. You know, you want them to be at their top
100%,
level.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's just, I think it's just that support and respect and kind of that admiration you have for that person when they do well. I think that's how it comes down, really.
For me, it'd be the hardest part. Well, can I do it as a profession? So I think it's trying to stay in the routine and, you know, not missing meals. I think eating for me is hardest part, you know, because you could easily just go off your diet. I mean, eating chicken, rice every day and mince and that. You know, and when you've got a missus as well, and you know, we tend to have the old takeaways and you want to go on dates and stuff,
every,
you know.
Day.
Maybe she wants to get drunk every day, it's hard, you know. So, but yeah, that's probably is the hardest part, I think, is the food and trying to stay the structure, you know, like you're always going to go off your diet, you don't want to train, you know, it's just hard, though. That's the hardest part for me, I think.
Eating 8 to 10,000 calories every day is pretty horrendous. you're walking around like a bloated whale most of the time, which isn't the most attractive. I remember when I met my wife, I had abs and I was quite lean.
Ah, me too, yeah.
And then kind of 3-4 years on, you're just a bloated mess eating 10,000 calories a day. So it's, yeah, it is what it is. When you look back at photos of us when we were ripped and lean,
oh, geez.
That's tough. But I mean, I didn't have grey hair, but anyway, there's always hair dye for that, isn't it? And you can't just go to the shops and buy clothes, you know, that's why Tom and I wear shorts most of the time. He's trying to find like jeans or trousers, whatever that fits, just so frustrating. You see a nice pair of jeans, you think, oh, they'd be nice. Try them on, they don't go past your calves.
See the shoes.
Yeah, it's our choice to be this big, but I think, you know, it's all about compromise with everything. Obviously, for us, Strongman is on such a pedestal, it's kind of almost number one in your life, but you also have to make time for, you know, your family, your loved ones, and
you have to have that balance.
Yeah,
so that's the hard part.
And certain things in life kind of
sacrifice.
You know, we've gone through a few issues with our family, you know, and that kind of shows you that, you know, family is such a big part, and they're so supportive for us. So it's only right for us to repay them and kind of show them the love and stuff. So as long as we can compromise with everything, I think it keeps it quite smooth.
So traveling's the worst for me, apart from like, I mean, I'd rather go on a 10-hour flight than a 2-hour. We fly the airplane and stuff, but yeah, it's a nightmare, you know, especially if you have to sit beside someone or you know, you're in the middle. My legs are extra long, my feet are long, everything's long on me, so it just doesn't work.
So off.
And then like, I just got what you said there, bro.
So your kind of stereotypical kind of view, I think the public have on us is that we're, a lot of us are maybe not the most smartest and quite aggressive and, you know, maybe not the most approachable, but I think what the public have to realise is that we're just normal guys, you know what I mean? But we just happen to like lifting big, stupid, heavy things. And by doing that, we kind of swell up and get bigger. We're just normal guys, kind of, you know, we go to the gym, we come back home to the wives and whatever, and kind of chill with them. And we just want to just get on with life. It's just one of our hobbies. And I think, people shouldn't be scared when they see us walking. They maybe be scared when they see Tom walking down a dark alley.
I've got a baby face, I mean, come on. You get messages all the time saying, come lift my piano up the stairs, come lift my chair up the stairs. You're like,
who asked you to lift your piano up the stairs?
Yeah, someone asked us when we come back to lift the piano up the stairs. I'm like, oh, I don't just have this muscle for that kind of stuff, you know, so I'm a professional, I leave it for professional things.
Working full time and being a top level strongman or top level athlete isn't easy. I mean, I'm turning 35 next week. I started working off on oil rigs when I was 18, so it maybe took me a little bit longer to get to that top level, but certainly never. It's a hardship, yeah, but it's not an excuse. I wouldn't say I've not done well because I'm working a full time job. You get 24 hours in a day. You know, if I'm working 14 hours a day, I've still got 10 hours left in the day, you know, so I say kind of maybe 6 to 8 hours sleep, but I've still got plenty of hours to train. You know, obviously Tom can train full time, but it's hard for him sometimes to get into that routine because sometimes you get a bit lethargic because you're not kind of getting up at a certain time. But with work, I'm in that routine straight away, so it's easy for me to keep in that routine. No one ever has to convince me to train. I want to go and train. That's kind of, I've built in me now. It's part of my ethos or whatever as a person. I'm not ever going to not train, so it's just I go home, give my wife a kiss, right, and back out to the gym. That's it. And she gets a bit pissed off sometimes, but it's just the way it is.
For me, before the comp, I take a week off, so just like do nothing, like, you know, or stretch and stuff for a week. But yeah, all the way up to maybe 2 weeks out, it's heavy. I don't know, maybe I could deload them in a week off, and then just get, you know, you're nervous, everything just as good as you can get, and that's it. But I always take a week off, and regardless, and stretch, and just eat lots of food, and sleep, and rest.
So it's pretty much the same as well. Yeah, we've got like a, so say from now up until about it's like 8 weeks training block, basically.
Yeah, it's 6 weeks hard training,
yeah.
A week off, and a week like light weights, and a week to like get recovery and massage and stuff.
Yeah, but yeah, so for me, I would have my last training session, my last heavy training session, 2 weeks, a week, 2 weekends before the show, and I'd train that kind of 2 weeks before, up until the last weekend, to have like a lighter event session, and then from the Monday to Friday, you'd have those 5 days off just to rest. Like Tom says, eat plenty, get your physiotherapy, hot and cold therapy, get everything just back to the optimum. So your central nervous system is all kind of all firing all cylinders again, and then the comp comes on Saturday, and then we're ready.
I think that's the most important week as well. You know, like the last week is, you can, you know, training's important, but you have to get the last week kind of right, you know. I used to just want to train all the time, you know, right in my head, but when you get it right, that's when you feel your best.
Yeah, the recovery is so important. Yeah. Can't anyone do strongman? I think that's the beauty with strongman is that, yeah, anyone can. You know, there's different weight categories now. We just had the world's official strongman games in Daytona, Florida.
Under 105s.
Yeah, I mean, there's ladies categories, different weight categories for women, different weight categories for men.
And some people think for like being 5 foot, oh, I can't do strongman, but like there's a lot of, like around 6 foot 8, and like if you're 5 feet, you can press something above your head, you know, it's easy. But yeah, if you're 5 foot, there's events you're going to struggle with. If you're 7 foot, there's events you're going to struggle with. It's just working hard, and yeah, but anyone can do strongman. It's fun, isn't it?
But I think that's why people, like the working class, I mean, that's where we're all working class guys that kind of compete in strongmen. And I think that's what attracts a lot of people to it, because you can just see we're just, you know, a lot of us do have full-time jobs. We're still working mechanics, you know, working the rigs, doing whatever, you know, we're all just kind of normal guys and now women as well competing. So it's more attainable, I think, than the likes of becoming a Premier League footballer or, you know, a top class rugby player, golfer.
You know, volleyballers are really strong, you know.
So like the strength, I mean, it's such a purist of sport, either strong or not. So anyone can become strong. It's just how much you want to become that strong man or woman.
I was a weak man before I started. Let's see, hold on.
Yeah, you were.
I was like this.
All right, and we went to Dubai.
Lanky, met this boy. Well, he was my brother. Met him in the gym one day and he got me strong. I was like, whoa, this is cool. Popeye muscles I got. So my strength, obviously, Atlas Stones. I think I have the crown of King of the Stones right now. But yeah, Atlas Stones, I love deadlifting right now. My deadlifts is going up. So those two are kind of the events I enjoy training and the events I enjoy competing.
Yeah, so like, for my strengths, I mean, anything to do with pressing, log press, I'm one of the top boys in the world at the moment. Certainly with heavy reps, anything with repetitions in a log. Out in Worlds here, I think I drew with Rob Kearney and Half Thor, hold the world record with Graham Hicks and Z for the most reps in a slate of log in a minute. So yeah, pressing's my kind of speciality, if you will. And you know, I'm pretty good at stones and moving events as well. Whereas Tom's exceptionally good at kind of deadlifting. It's coming on now for me, which is nice to see. So hopefully get that up in our kind of 10, 20 kilos. And I think once I do that, then I'll be challenging for the, you know, the top titles. So for beginners wanting to start strongman, it's basically going to the gym and training. It's as simple as that. That's all we did, was go to the gym, get into, find a basic routine, you know, do 5x5, push, pull, press, whatever you want to do, but it's be consistent in what you are doing. I think it's just learning the basics, though, your basics. Yeah. Learn the compounds, do your deadlift, do your squats, do your bench press, do your overhead press, do those four and get them honed in. Yeah, I mean, anyone, you can watch any amount of YouTube videos, you can learn that. And then once you get those up to a certain level, let's look at event stuff. Okay, I want to pick up a sandbag.
Yeah. Log,
Suppose
an empty log's only what? You can buy them 30k, 40kg. And
Mirafit do a great empty log. But yeah, it's very. Some people can be a bit too overcomplicate things to a certain point. So if you're wanting to kind of do your event stuff, maybe look into getting a coach or. I mean, there's that much stuff in YouTube and social media.
Best,
I mean, look at the Stoltman Brothers YouTube channel. It's maybe doing us as athletes an injustice by saying this, but it's very simple. You know, you're picking up stuff. Your body adapts to the easiest. So picking up an Atlas Stone, I never got shown how to do that, but you adapt to that easy way of
doing it. You're basically doing strongman day-to-day life. You know, the way you pick up stuff in your house as well, you know, like.
Just keep it simple, I think, and don't kind of.
Keep it simple, be sexy, be big.
Yeah, exactly.
Three, things that will get you far, like.
Yeah.
Do you like that?
Yeah, whatever Tom says.
You know it's true, you'd do that. You get called big sexy, I think it's your choice, you know. Why get called an albatross?
One more, for luck. Yeah, that's a one. That's perfect.